Day 14, part 14. So my interactions with the lawyers. So, I never really intended this to have to go to a legal matter, but when I got served papers on February 23rd, 2018, for a lawsuit in Texas for I was being sued for $50,000 by Heather. That was the first time that I had even really thought about reaching out to lawyers to really go deeper, and that was only because I was forced to. So, because she had sued me, I immediately started reaching out to some of the lawyers here in South Dakota to find out kind of what my options are and what I needed to do. And they had basically said, because I was sued in the state of Texas, that I needed to basically get a Texas lawyer to represent me, because I'd only been in Texas for 2 days in my entire life, and to go from there. Well, during this time too, I did a story with Angela Kenneke from the Keloland News that was going to air about my story. And this story was going to air on April 12th, 2019. And they must have known about that, because on April 12th, 2019, my lawyer that I had hired down in Texas was contacted by Heather's lawyer, wanting to negotiate this lawsuit to prevent my story from airing. And I mean, they were willing to do basically drop everything as long as I promise never to say anything again about this situation, about Howard, about my interactions with her, just to basically shut me up. And I'm like, there's no way. I mean, they had that opportunity. They didn't think that I would probably go as far as what I did to have my story aired on Keloland. So it went back and forth all day long. And finally, I told them there's no way that I'm going to allow them to silence me, just like they did to my mom, in 1984. It's just not going to happen. So I proceeded with it, and my story aired on Keloland at the 6 a.m. It started at 6 a.m. and then it went on the noon news, the 2 o'clock news, the 5 p.m. news, 6 p.m. news, 10 p.m. news, and then also on midnight. So I mean, it was on quite a bit, which was great. I got a ton of exposure, shared it around social media. I think it's been viewed over 100,000 times now. It gave a little bit of a snapshot of kind of what was going on. The story doesn't get as in depth as what I'm getting here, but it gave at least a good overview of the situation. And once that aired, then I had something too to go to these lawyers now in South Dakota and say, hey, what can we do to change these laws, and what resources do I have available to me to fix this? And every lawyer that I spoke with said, well, in order for you to do anything about this, you need to change the law, and it's not going to be cheap. It's going to be very expensive and very drawn out. And each lawyer that I even got to entertain it was looking for anywhere between a $10,000 to $25,000 retainer just to get the process started. Well, I don't have that kind of money to do that. So it's an unfortunate situation where, regardless of right, wrong, or indifferent, if an error occurred, if there was deception that occurred, whatever, I don't have that kind of money to be able to fight this issue. So, it's one of those that I'm hosed, but I'm not gonna give up. I actually had a meeting today with my local legislator. It was a great meeting. I don't want to spoil anything yet, because that'll be a whole nother episode. But I had a great meeting this morning, and I feel that there's some real positive things to come. But thank you for watching. Please continue to share. Help me share the story. Get more people to like my page and to view my videos, because this January we need to make some changes in legislation, and it's going to take some people behind us to do it. So appreciate everything, and we'll talk to you soon.